In this video, we will derive expression for pressure exerted by the gas on the wall of container. See how to derive this expression. For this, consider cubical container. A cubical container. So that length of each side of this cubical container is equal to L. Length of each side of cubical container is equal to L. Then consider three-dimensional coordinate system for reference, assuming theta. Length of each side of cubical container is equal to how much? L. Here, L represents length of each side of container. Of course, cubical container. So that in this cubical container, an ideal gas is enclosed. And let us consider that L represents total number of gas molecules enclosed in this cubical container. Here, assume that this gas is ideal gas. Assume that this gas exerts equal pressure on all six surfaces of that container. And also assume that the molecules of the gas that we have taken in the container, it does not collide with one another. They collide with only walls of that container. So that the molecules are colliding with this wall S. All the molecules are colliding with that wall S. We will find pressure exerted by this gas on that wall S. We will find the pressure exerted by this gas on that wall S. To find the pressure exerted by the gas on wall S, take one molecule, suppose that V1 represents velocity of first molecule. V1 represents velocity of first molecule. Take this velocity in three components. X component, Y component, Z component. This component will be the Vx1, this will be the Vy1, and this will be the Vz1. Here, we have assumed that the molecule is colliding with wall S. Means, it's only X component is changing here, while Y component and Z component remains unaltered. Only X component is changing here. Assume that here, the wall, X component of velocity is changing only. It is colliding with that wall S. Here, momentum of molecule. Of course, first molecule, before collision, denoted by P1, it is equal to mass of that molecule into Vx1. This will be the momentum of that molecule before collision. After collision, the velocity will get reversed. Its Y component, Z component remains unaltered. Therefore, collision, after collision, momentum, after collision, momentum of molecule will be, momentum of molecule will be P2, right, minus of mvx1. Velocity get reversed, they are both written minus sign. From this we can write change in momentum of molecule. Change in momentum of molecule. Change in momentum of molecule. It comes equal to P2 minus P1, means minus mvx1, again minus mvx1, this is minus twice mvx1. This much change in momentum will take place in that molecule. By law of conservation of momentum, by law of conservation of momentum, we can say that here, equal amount of momentum will be gained by the wall L. Therefore, momentum gained by the wall S, momentum gained by the wall S, you get equal to momentum gained by the wall S. How much? It is equal to plus twice mvx1. This is the momentum gained by the wall S due to single molecule, that is due to first molecule. Find the rate of change of momentum to get force exerted by this molecule on wall L. Force means rate of change of momentum. To find rate, you must calculate here the time interval required for this molecule to perform two successive collisions on this wall L. First, find out time interval required for that molecule to perform two successive collisions on that wall L. To find this time interval, to find this time interval, use relation between velocity, distance and time. Time interval between two collisions we can find like this. It is equal to distance covered by that molecule upon velocity. How much distance will be covered, this, covered by this molecule during successive collision, two successive collision? When first molecule collide with this wall S, what happens? Velocity get reversed. It will go back to this wall and again will come back towards this wall. During this, the total distance covered by the molecule will come twice L, and this is covered with velocity Vx1. Therefore, we get time interval how much? Twice L upon Vx1. From this, we can write force. Force exerted by first molecule. Force exerted by first molecule on wall, it is equal to average momentum. And you know how to find average momentum? If we divide this change in momentum, if we divide the change in momentum by this time interval, we get here mvx1 square upon L. This is the force exerted by first molecule on wall. Write total force exerted by all N molecules. It is F equal to mvx1 square upon L plus mvx2 square upon L plus that mvxn square upon L. Take M by common in bracket, we get Vx1 square plus Vx2 square plus that Vxn square. This is
this addition we can replace from the v square, which is called mean square velocity of gas molecule. V square, which is called mean square velocity of gas molecule, for x component, it is Vx1 square plus Vx2 square plus that as Vxn square upon n. Means this addition we can replace. This addition you can replace here by n times V square, right here 1. You see it. Mean square velocity, therefore right here 1. Mean square velocity. This is m bar n into v square x. For x component. Therefore v square x 1. Now, by symmetry, we can consider here Vx bar or Vx square bar equal to V1 square bar equal to Vj square bar. By symmetry, we can consider this other Vx square bar equal to V1 square bar equal to Vz square bar. Therefore, total velocity V square bar we can write as the 3 times Vx square bar. By symmetry. Now assume that the molecules are moving in this direction. That is along y axis. Then assume that molecules are moving in this direction. Means by symmetry you can consider this. If mean square velocity of all the component is same, we can write total mean square velocity 3 times any one component. Mean square velocity of any one component. Means this can be replaced. This can be replaced in terms of V square bar like this. F equal to M bar L into 1 by 3 M V square bar. In terms of mean square velocity, total mean square velocity. Now you know pressure is always force upon area. Force we have calculated how much? It is 1/3 m into n upon l into v square bar divided by area of that surface, which is l square. We get here P equal to 1 by 3 m into n upon l cube into v square bar. This is the expression for pressure exerted by the gas on the wall of container. M means mass of single molecule. N means total number of molecules. This m into n will represent the total mass of the gas. In upon there is an L cube, which is volume of that container, means M into N upon L cube, it represents density of the gas. Therefore, we can write, here, pressure 1/3 rho into V square bar. Well, what is this V square bar? It is called mean square velocity of gas molecule. It is called mean square velocity of gas molecule. This is the expression for. This is the expression for pressure exerted by the gas on the wall of container.